This is part 3 of a series on attention networks. In this video, we will look at a sequence-to-sequence attention model. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice is generated by AI, text-to-speech. In the last video, we implemented a sequence-to-sequence model to predict time series. In this video, we're going to add a feature called attention to our sequence-to-sequence model. Let's take a look at the architecture of the Seq2Seq-Attention model and how to find attention scores and attention values. And let's implement this model with Keras and predict a time series. There are many papers that apply the concept of attention to sequence models. Among these, we will look at the method proposed by Luong et al. In their 2015 paper, Effective Approaches to Attention-Based Neural Machine Translation. Luong et al. Added such an attention layer to the existing sequence-to-sequence model. This allows the model to focus its attention on important parts of the sequence. In this video, we will implement the model illustrated in the figure on the right, which is the global attentional model presented in this paper. Additionally, section 3.3 of this paper proposes an input feeding approach. A model that applies this approach will be implemented in the following video. The sequence-to-sequence model we looked at in the last two videos is as follows. Each subset of input data consists of 5 sequential data points, and the recurrent layers of the encoder and decoder consist of 5 time steps. Encoder inputs are fed into the encoder, and decoder inputs are fed into the decoder, and the targets are output to the output layer. This time, let's add a time series embedding layer to the input layer. We add a regular feedforward layer here for the embedding layer. When 2 features x1, x2 are input, they are converted into a vector with a fixed size. If the number of output neurons is 30, the 2 features are converted into a vector with 30 elements. This is a vector representation for time series. For time series, this is not strictly required, but is optional. This is similar to the role of the word embedding layer in natural language processing. Now let's add an attention layer to this model. This is the sequence-to-sequence attention model. Before passing the output of the decoder to the output layer, the model refers to the output of each step of the encoder to determine which ones are more important and which ones are less important. We can use the concept of similarity to determine this. The dot product of 2 vectors can be used as a way to measure their similarity. This is called dot product attention. There are several ways other than the dot product, but we will use this method here. Compute the dot product between the first output vector of the decoder, D1, and all output vectors of the encoder. Computing the dot product of D1 and E1 gives a scalar value. And computing the dot product of D1 and E2 gives another scalar value. Then we can get a vector with 5 elements like this. Here, 5 is the number of time steps in the encoder. Applying the softmax function to this vector gives us the attention score. This is a probability distribution like this. This can be called an attention distribution. In this distribution, A4 is the largest and A3 is the smallest. That means D1 and E4 have the greatest similarity. D1 and E3 have the lowest similarity. Treating E4 as important and E3 as less important in the first time step of the decoder can help predict the target of the output layer. This is the basic concept of attention. Now we multiply the output vector of each time step of the encoder by these probabilities. This is the weighted average of the vector E according to the attention score. That is, the weight of vector E4, which has high importance for D1, will be high. And the weight of vector E3, which has low importance for D1, will be low. Adding them all up in this direction gives us a vector of the attention values. This vector contains a lot of information about the important E. Conversely, a little information about the less important E. And then we concatenate this vector with D1. This is the attentional hidden state vector that is passed to the output layer in the first time step of the decoder. We do the same thing for the remaining time steps. This is the hidden state passed from the encoder to the decoder. And this is the hidden state passed from the decoder to the output layer. This is the architecture of a sequence-sequence attention model for time series prediction. Next, let's look at how to get the attention score and attention value through a simple example. The outputs of each time step of the encoder are as follows. The shape of this output tensor is 1, 4, 3. The first dimension is the batch size of the data. The second dimension is the number of time steps of the encoder. And the third dimension is the number of neurons in the recurrent layer of the encoder. The outputs of each time step of the decoder are as follows. The shape of this output tensor is the same as that of the encoder's output. First, we compute the dot product of the encoder output tensor and the decoder output tensor. We can achieve this result using Keras's dot layer. Here, axes are set to 2, 2. That is, we perform a dot product so that the D2 dimensions are multiplied with each other. Except for the batch dimension, the 4x3 matrix and the 3x4 matrix, which is the transpose of 4x3 matrix, are multiplied. Then you can see that the D2 dimensions are multiplied with each other. The resulting tensor has the shape of 1, 4, 4. The first row vector is the dot product result for D1 and all E. And the second row vector is the dot product result for D2 and all E. This allows us to obtain a dot product tensor in one go. Then we apply the softmax function to this tensor. This is the attention score. The results are as follows. Then we multiply the attention score by the encoder output and sum them. We can achieve this result using Keras's dot layer. Here, axes is set to 2, 1. Multiply the D2 axis of the attention score and the D1 axis of the encoder output and add them. It's not easy to explain why we calculate it this way. Instead, let's verify the result. We multiply each row vector of the encoder output by the first row of the attention score in this way. Then we sum all the results row by row. And then we get this result. This matches the first row of attention value. Finally, we concatenate the decoder output with the attention value. The results are as follows. This is the attentional hidden state, which is the output of the attention layer. Next, let's build an attention layer using Keras. Let's find the attention value using the example from the previous page. The results are as follows. The results are in good agreement with those on the previous page. Now, let's implement a sequence-to-sequence attention model using Keras to predict time series. This is the code for teacher forcing, which is the training stage. We added a time series embedding layer and an attention layer to the sequence-to-sequence model implemented in the second video of this series. Let's just look at the parts that have changed from the previous code. Please refer to this video for the code of the sequence-to-sequence model. As we saw in the previous page, we write a function for the attention layer as follows. And we instantiate a feedforward layer for the time series embedding layer that will be commonly used in both the encoder and decoder. The size of the embedding vector is set to 30. When creating the encoder and decoder, we add the time series embedding layer to the input layer, respectively. And when we create the decoder, we add the attention layer to the recurrent layer. This completes the training model for sequence-to-sequence attention. Let's run this code. The training is complete. The train parameters of this model are stored in this file. Next, let's write a code to predict a time series using the trained model. In this code, we also add a time series embedding layer to the input layer of the encoder and decoder. And when we create the decoder, we add the attention layer to the recurrent layer. Finally, we also add an attention layer to our prediction model like this. Use the prediction model to forecast the time series for the next 50 periods. Finally, let's plot the last 100 data points of our time series and the 50 predicted future values. The past time series and the predicted future time series are as follows. The blue and red are the observed past time series. The green and orange are the predicted future time series. You can see that two sine curves with different frequencies are predicted. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. So far, we have implemented the sequence-to-sequence attention model to predict time series. This is a simple version. In the next video, we will add the input feeding approach presented in section 3.3 of Luong's paper to this model.